My original dream was never to have a big wedding. My dream was to always elope, go to Spain. When I first told my mom, she was like, no, you can't do that. And I was like, yes, I can, watch me.
I wanted her to have the whole experience, from soup to nuts, whether she likes it or not.
So the wedding we're actually having, we're going to, it's gonna be huge.
Aside from mom, Pam, Hillary's brought her father, brother, and fiancé, Steve.
Hillary's original idea was to elope, but
I do like the traditional wedding, so we conformed a little from that first idea.
Oh, it's so nice to meet you. Congratulations to you, honey.
Steve is so great. He makes me laugh all the time. I think that's why we get along great. All the weddings we've gone to, he's picked every dress, so he might as well be here for the most important one, right?
Number one, tell me a little about the wedding, and then tell me your price point.
Okay. Price point, I'm trying to keep it low. If we could do between $1,000 and $3,000, because I didn't want my parents paying a ton of money for a wedding. I'm a mess.
Why?
Like, it's the hype, you know? It's the dress, so everything is just, you know, making me panic a little. The dress I see myself in is something that makes me look, you know, sleek and slender. This is what I particularly like. My family has other ideas, but...
So. What does your family have in mind?
I don't know. My mom, like, her wedding dress was all lace. It was beautiful, but it's not my style.
Hillary is my kind of gal. She's no fuss. She's looking for something very simple, elegant, easy to wear. And she's a little nervous knowing that her mom might have something else in mind for her. Did you always want a big wedding, honey?
No, not at all. I wanted to elope.
You sound like me. I had a small wedding in a restaurant, about 50 people. I didn't do a full mass service like a good Italian girl.
Yeah, we're not.
I just did a blessing. And you know what? I look back now, and I'm really sorry that I didn't embrace it.
Really?
Yeah. Should we show your family?
Yes. My family's here for support.
But sometimes support in this family can feel like punishment.
There you go.
Dress number one.
Okay. Face the mirror for me.
Okay. I like where the waist goes in, and this hits like all the right places. It's not too low, it's not too high.
I'm not a fan. I don't like the bodice and the shoulders.
I was not happy with the dress at all. The minute she walked out and I saw her in the mirrors, no, not at all.
It's slightly disappointing because it's not exactly what you have in your head.
No, not at all.
Hillary liked it, but the more we stood out there with mom and dad, it started to escalate. All right, let's try the other one on.
Okay.
Be careful. This is beautiful.
I like this one much better than the other one. I like it a lot simpler, a lot plainer. This is definitely more the avenue I'm looking to go down.
Hillary loves the dress, but the real judge still awaits.
Okay.
All the poof is gone away.
It's very elegant, but a little too plain.
Oh, see, I like that, though. It suits me, it suits my personality. It's very beautiful in the simplest way. And people are going to focus on me, not so much, you know, how much glitz and glam is on the dress.
It still didn't have that pop. It needed something. It's not wowing me. I think it needs something. Well, I think it's too plain.
Everything we were finding was close, but not perfect. The simple, yet with a little bit of shine to it, it was actually a little difficult to find.
A little beadwork, and I think it'd be perfect.
I don't think so. I like it just the way it is.
No.
I think it is a great dress. It was very quiet elegance. It was her.
Hillary, she loved it. She really did. But I think mom had an entirely different image in her head of the dress Hillary was going to wear.
Dress number two is a hit with the bride and her father, but mom isn't ready to surrender.
I want her to come out here. I look in the mirror and I want to go, why? Then you know it's right. I haven't done that yet.
Audrey and Hillary are digging in for a long battle.
After that second dress, every dress I brought in, she just kept saying, but don't you have anything like that? I mean, that was her dress.
I hate it.
You hate it?
I hate it. That I hate. This isn't it either. Going from one dress to another, to another, to another, it felt like we were just going around in a circle.
While Hillary's been chasing her tail in the dressing room, in the main salon, the family's been waiting. The trouble is, this bride has already made her choice. Dress number two.
That one just said you.
That was way more me. I don't know, I'm confused.
Tired of waiting for Hillary, Pam and Steve head to the fitting room.
I don't like the way I'm feeling right now.
Why? What are you crying for?
What's the matter?
Frustrated.
I walked in the dressing room, my daughter's standing there crying. Crying.
Don't cry. Don't cry. I don't want to cry. So you don't cry. You don't cry, I won't cry.
It's supposed to be a happy day. Why she's standing there crying, I don't know.
When you know what you don't like and you're looking at all these dresses that you tried on, you don't want to look back and settle.
I honestly didn't hate the dress without anything on it.
You want to try on a dress first, right, with a little something going on.
Hillary's coming undone because she already knows the dress she wants and her family's not being supportive.
I was getting the impression that either I wasn't being heard or I wasn't explaining correctly what I wanted.
Give me 5 minutes, I'll go through the whole place. I'll put you out 3 or 4 dresses that we know we're after and boom, you could try them. I want it to be the happiest day of her life, whether she likes it or not. The dress isn't there.
No admittance, I'm not breaking rules.
I didn't care if I had to go to the back room where it said no admittance, I admitted myself. Just give me 5 minutes.
One of the reasons that we really don't like people to go in the stock room alone is because we have about 1,500 dresses. And unless you're escorted, you're really not gonna know what you're looking at.
But what Pam lacks in knowledge about the store, she makes up for in confidence.
Yes, 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 that is it. This is good. All right, let me show her this.
Go ahead.
All right.
You have to look at their facial expressions and look in their eyes how they feel. It wasn't a hit.
Audrey's been patient with Pam so far, but now she draws the line.
I can't believe it. Okay, I got that.
I actually took it all off the hanger and everything. Let's get it on.
I really don't like your pushy mom on my time. You can be a pushy mom on your time.
And then they scooed me out the room.
Pam's lost one battle, but will her dress choice be a winner?
I don't know. I still just feel it's too much. Do you know what I mean? It's not me. This is what she would pick for me, which is exactly what happened. And this is not what I would pick.
Even though Mom didn't like dress number 2, Hillary can't stop thinking about it.
That one just said you. The second dress, it was plain, it was simple, it was figure flattering. Hillary liked the idea of the dress. And I knew I could make that idea work.
So Audrey's going to take dress number 2 and make it into something Mom can love.
I'm gonna try to rig it up where she has all the qualities in the dress that she's looking for. Mom wanted a little bling, and I knew what I was going to do. I picked up a little beaded belt, and I put a little bit of embellishment behind it.
The little details make a big difference.
In a last-ditch effort to get Mom on board, Audrey's transformed dress number 2 with a nip, a tuck, and a little bling. Now, let's hope it works.
Oh, see? Now that's perfect.
That looks like the dress you had on
before. No, wait, just be quiet. She looked beautiful, beautiful. I knew it the minute she stood up on the pedestal. That is it. Perfect.
Ooh. I got emotional and I couldn't even say, you know, this is the one. No, they just saw it. And I saw it on them too. What do you think?
Yes, I'm lucky. Yes. I was speechless at first. I was just wowed.
We did it.
Yes, 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 that is it. Perfect, perfect, perfect. She's my best friend, and now she's gonna be Steve's. And yeah, the day is almost here, and I'm gonna have to deal with that. And I'm having a hard time along the way.
Done.
Done.
Exactly.
Done. That was easy.
That was easy.
Just keep in mind, I was the one that said it first, number 2.
Number 2 altered.